In this lesson, we will learn how to apply sprite animations to 3D objects. Animation in the sprite renderer is done by swapping images. It is very intuitive and has the advantage of producing results in a short time. However, since 3D objects use mesh renderer, it is impossible to apply sprite renderer. So let's see together how to implement sprite animation on 3D object. First, let's take a look at how ghost characters are created. A character is made up of two meshes, body and face. Let's take a look at the UVs of the face. The texture applied to the face contains three expressions. I'm going to switch the expression in Unity via the texture offset function. If you look at Unity's standard shader, you can see the offset function. If you change the x-axis value of offset, you can see that the texture is moved. Since I put three 170 pixel wide images into 512 pixel wide images, each width is divided by a ratio of 0.332. Now let's create a new animation file. After clicking the Add Property button, if you look at the sub-items of Mesh Renderer, you can see the material underscore main text.st property. Let's add this property to the animation. The Z value of this property corresponds to the X value of offset. Let's change the Z value to change the facial expression. As noted earlier, facial expressions are placed every 0.332 units along the x-axis, so the third facial expression is located at 0.664 units. This depends on how you configure your texture atlas, so you will have to calculate this ratio yourself. We created an animation of the character blinking their eyes. But there is a problem. The movement of the texture is revealed as it is. This is not our intended sprite animation. Let's solve that problem. If you look at the bottom of the animation tab, you'll find the curve option. If you look at the change value of Z, you can see that a curve is applied to each animation key. This curve causes interpolation between each animation key. However, we only want the image to be swapped, so no interpolation should happen between each sprite. With all animation keys selected, when you click right button of mouse, you can see options. Then select constant in the both tangent settings. This will cause the curve applied to each animation key to disappear, and the transition between the keys will turn into a straight line. If you click the right mouse button again, you can see that all animation keys have changed to broken state. Let's play the animation. The problem was simply solved. Sprite animations can be applied to many different objects, not just the character's face. It can be used for advertisements on buildings or even on TV screens. Please use it appropriately according to your game project. That's all for today's video. Thank you, see you next time.